Hi guys, in this video I'm going to show you how easy it is to move your domain to Namehero. I'm also going to show you how easy it is to install WordPress in Namehero. Make sure to like and subscribe for future videos. Hi guys and welcome to the video. If you're currently watching it, you're probably thinking about moving your current domain to Namehero, or you're trying to change your current DNS settings to point to Namehero. This is an extremely easy process and I'm going to show you how to do it. As you can see on screen at the moment, there really is a lot of features that Namehero offer. All plans come with unlimited storage, unlimited bandwidth, and unlimited email accounts. If later down the line you wanted to buy yourself another domain, Namehero offers this service also. By buying your domain from Namehero, it'll avoid you having to move it at a later date, which in turn could also save you money in transfer fees. Now, at a later date, I will be uploading a video on how to migrate your existing website to Namehero. Now, until then, Namehero do offer a migration service. Now, I think it's a good time to log in and see what the dashboard looks like. So what you'll notice on the left is Namehero have your address, just in case you get lost. You can also add contacts, shortcuts, and along the top row, you have My Cloud, Domains, Unpaid Invoices, and Tickets. Further down, you can see which price plan you're on, register a new domain, see recent news, and on the right-hand side, you also have access to your support tickets. On the left, you've got My Cloud, and you can check what price plan you're on from My Services. Underneath that, you've got your domains that you have registered. Moving down again on the left-hand side, you've got billing, and this is where you can check your invoices and change your billing information. Finally, on the left-hand side, you've got support. This is where you can open and raise tickets, check the latest news, and check on the network status. Now I'm going to show you how to move a domain you bought on a different platform to Namehero. For the purpose of this video, I'm going to be moving a site I purchased at Godaddy to Namehero. The first thing we want to do is find our Nameservers for the site we want to move. You can do this by clicking on accounts on the right hand side and clicking on my products. Wherever you're buying your domain from, it should be as easy as this to find your Nameservers. All I need to do is scroll down the page and find the site that I want to change my Nameservers from. So there's my site there. I need to click on the three dots, click on manage DNS and scroll down the page. There's always a pop-up when you don't want one, but scroll down to the bottom of the page and you'll see there's your Nameservers. Now we need to go back over into Namehero, and once we're there, we're going to have to find our Nameservers for Namehero. All we need to do is click on My Cloud, wait for the page to load, and click on our plan. And as you can see, there is our Nameservers. All you need to do is copy and paste these over into your GoDaddy account. With the first one copied, we're going to have to head over into GoDaddy and click on Change. And then we're going to have to click on the button that says enter my Nameservers, where it says advanced. Give it a click, and once the page loads, paste your Nameserver into the top box. Then go back over to Namehero and copy the second Nameserver. Just like last time, you're going to have to paste this one into the second box. Once you've pasted it in, click save. You'll then see a pop-up message, and this will say that any changes may result in your site being taken from public view. You're going to have to click yes and click continue afterwards. And that's it. Once the page loads, you'll see that it's been successful in the top right hand side. Now, it is important to say that it is not necessarily instant that your Nameserver will change and update straight away. It can take up to 48 hours. Normally with a new website, it only takes about 20 minutes. Now, to make sure that we can access our website from Namehero, we need to add it to our domains list. So the first thing we're going to need to do is click on Login to cPanel. Now that the page is loaded, we need to scroll down and look for add-on domains. You can also find it by clicking in the search bar on the top row there and typing in add-on domains. Whichever way you find it, give it a click. What you're going to have to do here is type in your domain name. And what this basically does is creates all the subfolders and folders that are needed for your domain. Just finish off typing this in, .com. All you need to do now is click add domain. And as you can see, all the folders have been made. I have actually clicked this twice. Yep, so I was expecting a warning message or an error message saying that it's already been added. That's not a problem. All I need to do is click on go back, and it should say at the top of the list there, which it does, DIY Websites Pro. What I am going to do is see if the name servers have updated yet. So if I give it a quick reload. Okay, so it's not live now, but you can see there has been some progress made because it does say there is cPanel on the bottom of the page there. What we can do in the meantime is install WordPress onto our website. And that's the great thing about Namehero. You can start working on your website and domain, even though it hasn't actually finished moving over yet. What we're going to have to do first is go into our cPanel, scroll to the bottom of the page, and click on WordPress. Once the page loads, click on the little icon at the top and click install. And from the drop down, select the website that you want to install WordPress onto. All that's left to do is scroll to the bottom of the page and add our theme to our website. There is a lot you can choose from. All you need to do is click on the Show All Themes button. The theme I'm going to select here is 2022. Just click the Select Theme button and just click Yes for the image copyright. All that's left to do is click the Install button. What you'll notice at the top of the page is a progress bar that will show you how far along you are in your installation. This only normally takes a few seconds to do, but it can take up to 4 minutes. Once it has finished installing, it will say congratulations. So what you need to do now is click on the WordPress icon at the top and log in to your website. And as you can see, WordPress has loaded and you can start editing your pages now. If I visit my page, it should load like it has. In upcoming videos, I will show you how to install Elementor and Rank Math. I hope you found this video useful. If I have inspired you to buy Namehero, then please do use the link in the top of the description below. It is an affiliate link. It doesn't cost you any more to use, but it does give me a very small percentage of Namehero's profits if you choose to use it. Thanks for watching and see you next time.